not, because this will get me to 70. I'll do well behind things. I'm going to stand right here. First of all, just to have a banker on a panel of rainmaking discussion is a real coup. Because if you follow our industry, that's kind of like having an Eskimo show up at the suntan lotion convention, probably. Way apart. But let me first ask about myths. Who's old enough in the room to remember a show called WKRP in Cincinnati? Who was the salesman?
Herb Tarlin.
Herb Tarlin. What did Herb look like? What was Herb's deal?
Plaid jacket.
Loud, plaid jacket, big personality, right? And he was always hitting on Lonnie Anderson, right? Is that the salesperson, rainmaker stereotype, on the extreme, kind of loud personality? Let me tell you about Ken Hill. You don't know Ken. Ken and I used to work together back in the early 90s in North Carolina. Ken was a short guy, not especially remarkable physically, not a big personality. He wore glasses, very plain. And Ken thanked every doctor in Raleigh, North Carolina. How many of y'all would like to have doctors as customers? Anybody in this room? You would. And I watched Ken, and Ken, what did Ken do? Ken was dependable, he was trustworthy, he was knowledgeable, proactive, and accessible. He was an introvert, and he listened great. I think I heard somebody say something about that. But Ken was dependable, reliable, trusted, proactive, and accessible. He didn't have the big personality, but he quickly became known for those attributes across the medical community in Raleigh, North Carolina. He banked them all. So that debunks a myth. The introvert, the dependable introvert, is often your best rainmaker. Now let's talk about competitive advantage, and I want to talk about CNF Bank for just a moment, and a guy named Larry Hill. As you see, you've got to do something real, remarkable, and unique. Your bank, your company has to do something tangible, different. And most community banks say what is their competitive advantage? Great customer service. We're your neighbor, right? We all say that, but if we're all saying it, what does that mean? Nothing. What do you do better than anyone else? What do you do that no one else does? You look at Chick-fil-A, guys. They do something remarkably different than any other fast food restaurant. Think about what is distinct. Larry is behind that. His integrity, selflessness, and commitment to the community. Means he's all about small businesses, means he's about families and helping people get what it is they want, do it better than anyone else. And the last thing I want to talk about is ultimate rainmaker strategy, and maybe the reason I got up on the stage or ended up here is a guy named Dad. And Dad was about 15 miles or so from here, 10 maybe in Bon Air. He was the rector of St. Michael's Episcopal Church. Now my dad had to get others to believe and something they couldn't see, and write checks to it every Sunday morning. Right? How did he do it? Very simply, he was devoted to others. All the way devoted to others. Most salespersons, most rainmakers want to tell you everything about what they do, how great their product is, or why my bank is exactly what you need. But does any of that matter? What matters? How can I help? Whether it has to do with banking or not. When you look at the little Speilberg top 10, I got this Letterman thing, so I did this last night, ran out of printer ink at 4:30 this morning. You'll see. You know, one time I walked in and I actually helped this guy change a tire on a forklift because that's what he needed. And that was that. So, you know, your ultimate rainmaker strategy, make your day about others. Be a servant. Yourself aside. Put your brochures aside. Put your cards aside. Everything that you think about, what you think your business is great at, put it aside. And look transparently at that person and say, what can I do to help this person? Whether it has to do with my industry.